The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hi, everybody. Welcome. My name is Neil Caden. I'm your moderator for this session. This session is Sakai 10 Upgrading on the Bleeding Edge, and it's being presented by Jose Mariano Luján, who is a technical engineer in computer science from the University of Murcia with experience for IT and higher education. During the last 4 years, he has been working in the ICT area from the University of Murcia and involved in the release and maintenance of their Sakai deployment. He's also responsible for the technical coordination at an online master's program. He has participated in international conferences like EduLearn and EuroSakai. He's been active in the Sakai community since 2010 and is currently in charge of leading the S2U team. The S2U stands for Spanish Sakai Users. And before I hand it over to him and his colleagues to present, I want to mention just a couple of housekeeping issues. You are all on mute except for the presenters. So if you have any questions, please use the questions panel in the webinar, and we'll be monitoring those and either getting the questions answered during the presentation or towards the end. And this session is being recorded. Thank you, and I'm going to hand this now over to Mariano.
Yep. Welcome, everyone. I don't know what time is there right now, but here in Spain it's almost dinner time. So we appreciate you all being here in this session. We know it's a great conference, and there's a lot of rooms simultaneously. So we appreciate your time. So first of all, already Neil introduced me. I'm here also with Sabina, who is a project manager for the Sakai instance here at the University of Murcia, also with Juanjo, who is the lead developer, a recent Apereo fellow, PMC member, and then some other colleagues who are watching us right now. So we are representing the work of a lot of people, and we want to make sure that everybody is recognized for their efforts. So, thank you. So now, let's move. Yeah. So first of all, so who are we? We're gonna pass this very quickly. But for those of you that don't know us, we're the University of Murcia. We're located in the southeast of Spain. Here is some data so that you get an overview of the size of our university: around 33,000 students. 2,500 instructors. We have around like 55 bachelor degrees and some masters. We have some data over there of the active instructors and students. We're required to do some queries each year. Those queries are mainly checking only if they've uploaded some resources in the case of instructors, and for the students if they've checked some resources from the Sakai instance. And that beautiful building over there is where we work. That's the color of the sky that we have every day. So would love to hear you back, but it's impossible. So regarding our Sakai deployment, this is we come from a homegrown environment. The University of Murcia built their own LMS back in 1998, so they had quite a lot of people in their team involved on their LMS. So over the years, they built a lot of custom tools that were in that past LMS. So when we had to move to Sakai, all of these tools had to go also into Sakai. So to mention some of them, we have like official records that are connected to the student information system. We also have like calls for exam, our own syllabus tools, site creation. We control how the instructors create their own sites, a tool for synchronizing every site. It's maybe you know that now in Sakai 10 there was a new tool, site perms, something like that. I think it was made by Unicom. We've been having that tool like kind of that tool for over like 4 years now, but it was our own tool. And also, yeah, some optical reader exams and so on. So we have quite a lot of, quite a few tools that had to go into Sakai. So yeah, here it's a screenshot there from last year, and to give you an overview like of how many sessions we can get, like this is in a peak season, maybe July is when June, July when the final exams are, maybe 12 midday, that's where we get more connections to Sakai. So we started in 2010 with Sakai 2.7.1, and then we moved to 7.2. And that was we ran a pilot during 1 year. If you take a look at the screenshot that is over there, that's a screenshot from the presentation that we did in Paris in 2013. So briefly, we were not going to go deeply into this, but in 2010 we ran a pilot with 2.7.1. In 2011, we switched every single degree and every single master degree to Sakai. So our old platform, let's say, was gone away back in like 2011, and then in 2012 we started to join a bit more the Sakai community, because until then we were doing everything on our own, maybe checking the dev list and things like that, but not contributing anything and not thinking about the community. You know, like, didn't realize how this was supposed to work. So when we went to the Euro Sakai in 2013, we had already in our minds that we were going to switch to 2.9.1, and we were really worried about that, because we had a huge amount of local patches. None of those were contributed to the community. We want to make a special mention here to Alan Baer, who has always been has been always supporting us or mentoring us on how to move through this community. So he told us in that conference in Paris, we presented this cube that is there, that was our view back then of the community, and he told us that we had to get more involved in the community, and that we had to, in order to avoid the, if you take a look at the on the right side of the picture, if you take a look at that circle, that was our concerns back then. So his advice was to, you know, try to get more involved and try to make all of this available to the community, and try to attend some of the calls, Sakai Core call that is on Thursdays, and things like that. And we also started to work a bit more closely with the S2U, which is a group of really talented people from different universities and some companies here in Spain, and we're working together to try to improve Sakai. So back then, this was 2013, our main problems were a lot of custom tools, a lot of custom patches. We had added some features to Sakai, but they were inner instance. So what we got from there was that line at the bottom, that is, don't patch your instance, try to fix the trunk. That will help you, and for sure it will help other people. So now to the upgrade to Sakai 10. So that's why probably you are all here right now. So this is how our Sakai 10 instance look right now. Let's get a little deeper into how the process went. So first of all, when Sakai 10, you know, was about to be released, we started to think about the when we were going to do the movement, you know. So we had to look for, try to analyze our motivation to move to Sakai 10. So on one side, we had all the great improvements that were coming with the new release. So we were aware that Lesson Builder had a lot of new improvements, quite a lot, the menu and everything. We were aware that sign up was included in the release. You know, assignments with their peer review, group submission. There was some interest here in the University of Murcia to try to see if Sakai was a platform for able to do MOOCs. So we were, you know, also interested in that. Also drag and drop, profile photo, you know, all those kind of things that came with Sakai 10. And also there was also some other motivation. So as we mentioned before, we wanted to get more involved and we needed to get closer to Trunk. So that was also another motivation. So that was more on the technical side. So here, when we did the balance between both of these things, we found out that, you know, the new improvements that came with the release, some of them were good, but some others were good, but not that good for us because we already had signed up for over 2 years. We started using it as a country tool. We don't have an intensive use of Lesson Builder. We are aware that it's not that much use between our instructors. Also, MOOC's motivation was a bit, you know, dying down. They were going into other platforms and so on. So it wasn't really, we weren't really that motivated to provide all those new features to our faculty, rather than having a, you know, a technical decision, a technical motivation to try to do this and try to get closer to Trunk and then try to contribute everything that we can and try to get more involved. Because one of the things that happened to us when we were upgrading to 2.9 was that we contributed quite a lot of things. When, you know, we went to all these calls, we were aware that the things were going into Trunk and we were really happy. But we, you know, after that, after seeing the commit going into Trunk, we kind of forgot about everything. So we, you know, we weren't really following the whole process of each ticket. That it's supposed to, you know, maybe if you want to have it in the next version, maybe in 10, you need to try to, you know, test it then in a 10x branch and then make sure that somebody that does the merge back to that branch. So mainly motivation, we can say that it was a technical decision, not like it was in 2.9 that was, we were really motivated for our users that needed new functionality and needed new features. So with all of this in mind, we drew an initial plan, and the plan was to try to repeat what we did for 2.9. So we were aiming to deploy 10 after it was released. So that was July. That is a really good date for us because usually everybody's finishing their exams and people are leaving to go to the beach and so on. So that's a good period to do a migration. Here we have to mention that even before making that decision, we were already aware that, you know, someday we were going to move to 10. So what we tried to do from an institutional point of view was to try to participate more before the release. So we tried to join all the test feds, try to report bugs before the release was you know, ready for everyone, because we were aware that it's easier to fix all those things and it's easier to get people's attention if you do that before before 10 or before 11 or before each release is out of in, you know, for everyone. Some things that we did right after it was released was, I have to say that we actually made a plan to try to migrate in July. So we actually set up a date that it was the end of July. Around that period, it was when this virtual conference was going to be announced, and we were like, okay, we're going to do this, and we will be presenting or upgrade in that conference. So we actually had a date for July. Yeah, I have to mention here that in order to, you know, to manage all the fixes that we handle here in the University of Murcia and everything, we had to set up a couple of nailies. One is running at 10 right now, and the other one is running at run. And we apply every patch that we develop. We tested them before even trying to go to share it with anyone in the community. So after Sakai 10 was released, it was right after the Apereo conference. With that date in mind, we started to do some local modification. We started to do some testing here, and we also added a page in Confluence to try to share the story as we did from 2.7 to 2.9, because we believe that this is one of the main reasons to be in open source is because you get help and you get support from other people, and also you have to be willing to contribute your findings and your everything that you fix and so on. So we were aware that we were once of the few institutions that were trying to migrate to 10 back in July. So we started to do this Confluence page, and you can take a look after the session, and you will find some interesting information over there. We hope that is interesting information for you. Okay, so excuse me. Here is how we've been working since we started to contribute our things to Sakai community. If you take a look on the left side of this workflow, that's what we used to do with our own LMS, and what we did during the first, when we had 2.7 into, we migrated to 2.9. You know, we had our Sakai instance, we apply our custom scheme, then we do some test first, locally. If it's something is wrong, we fix it and we put it into production, and that's all. So after, and in our way to 2.9, what we started to do was to add the part that you see on the right, that is like if you find a problem, a local problem, you structure reports a problem to your help desk. You try to, the first thing you have to do is you try to see if that is also it's happening in Sakai, in maybe nightly, or if you run into 2.9, maybe in a 2.9 instance. If it is, then you try to make a Jira, try to fix it run, then create a patch, then use that to fix your code, apply it to your local process. And then we were working, as we mentioned, we were working with the SGU. So we had a call every week, and we tried to share our patches and our concerns in that call. And then we do some QA over there. So if, let's say, the University of Murcia fixes something, somebody from maybe University of Lleida or University of Public University of Navarra will do the QA, and then we'll try to make it available to the community through a CLA release team call that is on Thursdays. And then when it's fixed, it gets back to Trunk, and that's all we were aiming for, until 10, until our migration. So going back to our migration, we had to do some QA also here. We always try to reproduce best practices that we see in the Sakai community. So we gathered together all the developers here, try to get some instructors also, and then just test around. And before, as I mentioned, when we were moving to 2.9, we'll just fix our problems locally. But now what we're trying to do is that if we find something within our local QA, we try to Jira that, and then try to fix it for everyone. Or maybe for sure we're not able to fix everything. So, but when it's in a Jira, maybe it's somebody else, and that has happened a lot. Somebody else will take care of that, because it's a problem for not just for you, but for a lot of people. So, okay, what happened to us? We weren't hoping to find as many bags and things that we found. Let's say we're in July, maybe middle of July right now. Everybody's testing here, and we're like, oh, assignments is not working this, and forums is not working this. So we started reporting some of the URLs and going that in the Confluence page. Suddenly, it was kind of a mess. So we tried to use a label in Jira to try to keep track of everything that we were finding, and also everything that maybe we didn't report a problem, but we found that out during our QA, and it was interesting for us, and it was important for us for our migration. So we just labeled that with that label. So if it happens to you that you are in Jira and you see the label, it belongs to us. If you fix some of those errors, we'll be really happy, and we will appreciate your effort. So one thing that was curious for us here was that we were aware that UCT, University of Cape Town, was doing the migration to 10. So Stephen Macquer was reporting quite a lot of things in Jira. So every morning when we came here, because they work in a different time zone, we will be looking at the URLs that he reported to see if that was going to affect us or not, because we were aware that everything that he was reporting was a 10 problem in that moment. That's why we have added those footprints here, and we send some kudos to them for all the things that they fixed during their migration. So main problems that we found before the migration. Some of these problems made us realize that we weren't going to be able to migrate or to upgrade before the summer. So I will say that right now we were targeting our migration to September, I think, was the middle of September. So here over the summer, during August, the university closes down. Some people work in the IT department, but most people were away for vacations. So some of the problems that we found, assignments. A lot of features have been introduced in assignments for Sakai 10. Some things that we found that, that they should work, they were not working as expected, or they were just actually giving you a report to the user, like not working properly. Also in Message Center, which we know that we do a lot of, we have an intensive use of Message Center. There was a new feature, the rankings. It's just not working, at least for us in Spanish. So, and we were not able to disable that. Resources. There was some new functionality introduced that you can restore files. It's like a Bing, I think is how you say in English, the trash folder. That functionality doesn't work with sections. So, and we do a lot of in intensive use of sections. So we had to disable that in order to move forward. Also in resources now, there was something that changed, and you need to have content release any in order to see. I don't know if you're familiar with resources, but a user can copy something from other sites into that particular site by using a drop down that is at the bottom that shows you all the sites that you are a member of and that you have permissions to see the resources from there. We were aware that was well used by your users. We don't give content reviews any to any of our users. So, that thing is not there for us right now. So, maybe small things, not too big, not too many things that we mentioned in the bottom, but enough to slow us down, and we weren't able to fix everything that we wanted. So Yeah, we were targeting September, but you know, we had to even slow down a bit more. So, but as we say at the bottom of this slide, and not everything is wrong, and that's why we're still here, and that's why we're sharing our story, and that's why we believe in the community. Yeah, Sakai still rocks. We want to move it forward. So,
Mariano, this is Neil. Put a call out to people listening. If anyone has any questions, remind them to please put them in the questions poll. So I just want to make sure they knew they could do that.
That's great, because I had to drink some water. So
yeah.
Thank you, Neil. Sure. Yeah. I would love to see some of your faces, but this is quite the first virtual presentation that we do, and it's quite strange, to be honest. Okay, those problems that we mentioned, they were not that important, but this year were. The first one, we implemented the course management. There was a fix introducing, which is, Neil, if a question happened to be there, just stop me, no problem.
Okay.
So KNL 1183. That was a fix that it's only affecting people. That's actually intent, but it only affects people that are having the course management, because it makes some calls to the reference out group that just kills your instance if you run that code with course management. We had to revert that to get away of our 10 instance. Also, not too many institutions were using Oracle 10. So for the scripts, we were attending all these calls. As I mentioned, we were like, oh, this is not there. Nobody was actually aware of that, because maybe no one has gone through that before, or because some people just fix their scripts and don't share with the community. So this is a call for everyone to try to share everything that they find. Also, in roster 2, we found too many problems, especially with the Spanish or other locales. We are aware that with in English it works not that bad. So actually, we have right now 10 with roster 1. So we are trying to fix everything from roster 2 and expecting to move to that as soon as possible. So, okay, plan B. Actually, it's not plan B, it's plan C, because we had to target again our migration to October 25th. Guess what? Sakai Virtual Conference was actually on its way, and you know, we weren't even in 10. So that actually makes more sense to call this presentation the way it is right now, because we were like, oh, we're not going to make it. So we target Sakai October 25th as our date for the migration. Just here, some information. It was a window of 4 hours, and the service was out of not working, and in 3 hours it was already alive. But not everything worked as we expected, because it's in another slide. I will tell you in a bit. But the server went down a couple of times before we were able to find the problem. This is how it looks. This is how it looks our Sakai 10 instance. We didn't go too deeply into the user interface, because we are expecting to do that when Morpheus is out. So we're looking forward to Sakai 11 having Morpheus, and that's pretty awesome. We look forward to that. So what are these problems that we were talking about? The first one, it's related to Sakai 27.5.21. For some of you that are related with Jira, you can take a look after this presentation. This was a fix that was trying to improve the way forums was working. It was fixed. It was fixed actually for 10.2, and it had the label that it was fixed for 10.1, but actually it wasn't. So Yeah, we went into production, and you know, as I said, two times server went down, and we were trending topic in Twitter. You know, that happens to us quite a lot when Sakai has any problem or slows down. We're usually trending topic in your university. So yeah, so here the note for the communities, or what we wanted to say is that this at least should be included in the release notes. You know,
so got a couple of
easier with the community. Yep.
Got a couple of comments. So one is someone mentioning that she's really enjoying the speech, and it may be odd not to see them, but they're feeling very engaged. So good job.
Thanks.
And the other one is asking, are you hosting Sakai at your university? Did you work with any vendors during the upgrade? Or are you primarily using your own technical team and the Sakai community?
Just the last one. We haven't worked with any vendor at all, because as mentioned, that's why we knew that it was important to talk a little bit about us at the beginning, because we came from a homegrown environment, you know, that required a lot of people to work in that software. So that people haven't left just because we switched to Sakai. So we haven't, you know, we have just worked with our team and our community. So yeah, no vendor at all. But we appreciate a lot the help that we get from a lot of people that are from companies and that are investing their times in the Sakai, in every place, you know, in the list and everything. But we see it a lot in the Sakai core team calls, especially people from Lonesight and Unicorn and Asahi that spend quite a lot of time helping others. So yeah, but we haven't worked at all with any vendor or any contractor. And also, thanks for the questions. Also, another problem that we are having right now, haven't been solved yet. Since the migration, we're getting a lot of requests, a lot of tickets from our instructors, because they used to have content in resources. And we are aware that at least Dreamweaver used to tag new HTML files with the XMHTML thing. The new meme magic detection that was introduced in 10, it's not interpreting those files, at least in Internet Explorer. I think you say IA, right? IE, yeah. So we are having a lot of complaints about this. It's not been solved yet. But yeah, as we say, not that bad. So we expect more people moving to 10. We really need that in order to solve all the things that we've seen. And here we want to draw some conclusions. The first one is the lack of QA resources in this Sakai community right now. We know that some people are pushing hard on this, but it's just not enough. So this is a call for institutions that maybe they're not technical, but they can help report problems during QA. I mean, before actually, you know, they have their the new release in their system. So we need more people to get involved. Even before the release. So now is the time to get involved in 11. Don't wait until 11 is out to start testing and everything. We need to work on that, because a lot of the problems that we detected, they were really, really obvious. Just a bit of QA will make all those problems available, and you know, maybe community will find resources to fix them before the release. Yeah, we're still discovering a lot of things. Now we're in a process of making a Jira of everything that we have reported. So if you see a lot of activity from people with a long name, a Spanish long name, right now in Jira. That's all the people from Murcia reporting those years. And also another important thing, we had to upgrade the way we were working, because we've been working with the SGU more closely for over a year now. We had some proposals that we will mention now at the end of the presentation. So we'll take that in a few minutes. We need to, you know, to improve the way we're moving forward with our releases and try to make our future migrations easier. We were aware that this migration or this upgrade was not going to be as hard as going from 2.7 to 2.9, but still it was more time consuming than we were expecting. So now that's what we want to do. Just keep on moving. You know, don't stop. Here I already mentioned, but I want to mention it again, because it's been fundamental for us to send some kudos to the people from the Sakai core team call and from the people from the SGU. So what about now that 10 is in production here at the University of Murcia? Well, it's time to think about what we're going to do. We already had a couple of meetings within our team. Some things happened to us lately, good things. Juanjo, as I mentioned before, recently awarded as a Sakai Fellow and PMC member. He was also granted commit permissions to Tron. So now we can speed up things, but with great news comes great responsibility. So we want to improve the way we are working, to make sure that any code that we or someone from the SUU or, you know, some ticket from the community that we're interested in goes to Tron, we want to make sure that it's well tested and that is low risk for the community, because we are aware that that will be, you know, shared with everyone, with all of you. So
a couple more questions have come in.
Yep.
So one is, obviously, one question is, will the presentation slides be available? This session, by the way, is being recorded. But in addition, are you going to make the slides available?
Yes, we will make them available after the presentation. We will leave them in the forum.
Great. And the other question is, going back a slide where you talk about the problem with the HTML XMLS issue, is there somebody would like to know if there's a Jira for that? The MIME section.
Yeah, there is a Jira for that. We'll share it. Actually, it was Juanjo was working with Matthew this afternoon, right before the call. He was working on that. So the Jira is KNL 1278.
Thank you. That's all the questions for.
Well, it's related. I mean, yeah, it's related to that.
Oh, related to that. Okay.
Yeah. So So now, as we all those problems that we mentioned are in our production server. So, you know, it's you have a problem. So you want to fix them as soon as possible. So what we're trying to do is to target everything that we can for 10.3 and try to fix it as soon as possible. And then we want to upgrade as soon as possible to 10.3. So that we don't have to deal with local patches. You know, maybe we fix something before 10.3 is released and we have to apply it to our instance, because, you know, it's a problem for our instructor. So we want to be aligned with the community as soon as possible. So also another thing that we are aware of, I mentioned it before, it's like now if we are interested in a Jira, or a Jira that we reported, or even another Jira, we're going to try to follow that Jira until the end to make sure that if we want to have it in, let's say, Sakai 11, you know, try to push our efforts, try to make it available for 11 and not just leave it in Tron. That happened to us. And also related to the translations, because we announced, the Spanish community announced that 10 was the first release to be fully translated to Spanish, but we found out that that wasn't true. And it was because we were using TransFX to manage translation for the first time. No one updated TransFX with the crowding. Now we move to transfer crowding. No one was in charge of updating crowding. So we have crowding up to 100%, but crowding wasn't updated with what was in 10. So we were aiming for a Sakai 10 fully translated, and it wasn't like that. So now we're trying to Jira everything that we find that is in English. So, some solutions to all these problems that we mentioned. Okay, the SGU, I mentioned it before. It's a good team that is working really hard. This is a screenshot from a call. We hold calls every Tuesday, every single week, for 1 hour. Well, if it's not that many things, we just ended up before the time. But this is a screenshot you can see from the 23rd of September. And we were like, 12 people or 11 people. So, you know, there is a lot of interest within the community in Spain. We need to make that available for the community and try to improve the way we're working. So this is the new workflow that we're going to propose. We wanted to present it here. Some kudos to Alex from Jada that did the workflow with a lot of conversation that we had. So this is mainly what we want to do right now. This is to improve our QA. Okay, so now that we have some permissions to actually make things available in Trunk, let me go through this real quickly. So, let's say you detect Jira.
Just a few minutes left, by the way.
Okay, yeah, this is just the last slide. So, we detect Jira. We take it to a SGU call. We talk about the Jira. We explain the problem. We assign it to someone in the SU team. We try to resolve the Jira by proposing a patch. Someone tries to propose a patch. That solution goes to a revision by someone in the SU. If it's okay, and if it, we believe it's okay, we try to deploy it in a QA that we mentioned that we have. That we apply our patches, then we try to evaluate that by QAing. You know, if it's not working, then you just go around in circles. If it needs some more somebody to take a look, that is something that we are doing right now. We take it to the someone in the community, maybe into the list, or maybe to a Sakai Corp team call. We just share it with everyone, and then once it gets approval from someone else, from someone from the community. Maybe it's a problem related to ITNM, so we can, you know, talk to Gauhan from China, or maybe someone from Michigan or something like that. Then, you know, try to commit, and then, just go back again and try to work in another Jira. So you can take a look about the different workflow, the different options that you have here to go back to if someone tells you that the patch is not right and everything. And we're going to do this by using labels. That's the less intrusive way that we've seen to work in Jira. So we will be using all those labels to try to move forward with this workflow. And the last slide is about TransFX. We just moved, the Spanish community just moved to TransFX with a lot of help from the Japanese community. So we want to send a special kudos to them. We have already working with Jenkins. They provided us some scripts. So we're going to start working on this pretty soon. So we expect to have Sakai 11 fully translated to Spanish, and we hope that doesn't happen again as it happened to us with crowding. And this is just some thing that might be interesting to share here. This transifex thing came from the Apereo conference. In the there was a one of the sessions over there was about showcasing special projects and so on. And we contacted with the people, well, the people from Japan contacted us because they saw one of our presentations and they explained that they were using transifex, that they had some scripts and everything. And we started to have a relation with them and we've been working with them through emails for maybe, I don't know, maybe like 2 months now. You know, we have it now, everything ready. It will work for them, it will work for us, and maybe some others can take advantage of this. So, yeah, something for the whole community to be aware of. So, thank you. If you have any questions, please let us know. You can also send us an email or write in the forum. Yeah, we appreciate any question that you might have. Thank you.
So thank you, Mariano. Another kudos came in to say great job. And then I see that Juanjo posted, I think, KNL 1278 as the issue we were talking about earlier. So any other final questions as we wrap up here? We just have, I think, maybe one more question if anyone has additional question or comment. Okay, great. Well, thank you so much, Mariano. Really appreciate it. Thank you all who have attended as well, and for the questions and positive comments. And that'll conclude this session.
Thank you, everyone.